Who can turn a desert into a garden?
Oh my God, and the chocolate looks like this. It's gorgeous.
When you need to save crops and cattle from the deepest drought, who you gonna call? Call a beaver. Controlling water is what beavers have been doing for thousands of years. No one does it better. Every beaver family is dedicated to the job. Excavating, logging, building channels and dams. They build whole landscapes for hundreds of other creatures.
In 2002, we had the worst drought on record. The only places where we had water was where we had beaver.
So after we nearly eliminated them, some very interesting people are working to bring them back.
I am a hairdresser, honey. I like HBO. I want a toilet that flushes. But for some reason, when there's wildlife involved, especially beaver, I'm kind of fearless. Now I'm a hairdresser and a live beaver trapper.
Hi. Who's this sweet boy? Come here, sweetie.
With the other animals that I've rehabbed, you want to limit your contact. But for the beaver, because they're so family-oriented, they need to feel nurtured.
We brought you some new family members.
I'm delighted. I'm not sure how many there are. Hopefully, they'll be babies.
Yeah, yeah, this is good.
That's wonderful.
North America's fertile landscape is the work of one animal more than any other. But building a Garden of Eden isn't easy. You must fell hundreds of trees to dam a river. Then build a castle with a moat filled by a flood that spreads over several acres. Yet beavers don't look like the kind of animal that can change the world. Somewhat blind and slow, they seem like simple folk. But this overgrown rodent is an extraordinary engineer. The landscapes of Europe, Asia, and North America were once dominated by millions of these hard-working builders. Beavers are vegetarians. They gnaw through bark to eat the sugary layer underneath. Which makes them orange. They grow continuously and even self-sharpen. The pond makes it easier to move around the heavy logs they need to build their dams. Out of the water, it's a struggle. Stones help weigh down the base. The whole family works together, carefully interlocking the timber. They dredge mud from the pond bottom to seal the dam. Each pond traps several inches of sediment every year, so there's plenty of it. The young act as apprentice builders, learning the tricks of the trade. The final results are impressive. In the Rocky Mountains, beaver dams slowly filter billions of tons of water. The ponds build up soil and nutrients and help prevent floods and droughts. But hundreds of years ago, beavers were most valued for some If any animal can represent the spirit of North America, it should be the beaver. They battle the elements with courage, furnish a home they built themselves, and support a devoted family. Like the early settlers, beavers stock up a larder, then hunker down for the winter. For a pair of young wild beavers, the larder runs out before spring arrives. The male has to risk the predators to collect food. Beavers do slow down a bit in winter, but they still keep busy sorting out food and bedding. They need to. There's a new family on the way. And they are not alone. Inside the lodge are lodgers, a muskrat couple. They share the grass and branches the beavers supply. While it's minus 20 outside, it's rarely been known to freeze inside. So it's also a refuge for frogs and insects. There's a deer mouse family. It's quite a hotel to run all winter. Beavers, with their ponds in summer watering the desert, and their lodges and larders in winter, support the whole community. They all seem to get along. In fact, there was only one intruder the beavers objected to. And that was us and our little cameras, which they soon dealt with. Perhaps after all we've put them through for centuries, we owe them a bit of space.